Dear friends, we are in Casino, New South Wales. Some of you might not even know where this place is, but it's a massive farming area. And I'm with one of the farmers by the name of Phil. He's a good friend of mine. We're spending some time in Casino with the locals. There's good news in Casino. Let's talk to Phil. Phil, could you tell us what are the main things that you farm in this area?
The main kind of agricultural activity in this area basically is soybean growing. Cattle production is a major industry in the town, and the local casino abattoirs employs 800 people. Richmond Dairies exports large tons of cream to China and dairy products that have been specialised for overseas use. And one of the features in the area where I live, there's a large grain farm where they grow not only soya beans, but they grow organic rain-fed rice, which is a novelty, which I'd never heard of, because usually it's flood grain or grown underwater.
And how are the farmers doing in this area, Phil?
The farmers seem to be succeeding quite well in this area. There's no trouble with marketing their grain. At the present time, cattle prices have been very good, so there's been no problems with farm income at the present time anyway.
Having several campaign meetings here over the weekend, and we've been received really well by the people of the community of Casino. Rise Up Australia Party has a two-pronged strategy to support our farming community. One of which is to ban or reduce imports of fruit and vegetables which are coming into the nation, which will give our farmers a greater percentage of the agricultural market share. And the second policy we have is to impose import tariffs on incoming fruit and vegetables. We believe in supporting Australian farmers and producers so that they can also make ends meet and have a profitable outcome. And we believe in supporting them so that they can get their product onto supermarket shelves. And at the moment, there are imports coming in from places like China, the USA, and Mexico. Things like oranges, apples, mangoes from Mexico. All these things are coming in, and some of these things are 4 or 5 weeks old by the time they get into Australia. The quality is inferior, the nutrients is basically devoid, and meanwhile our farmers get the crumbs of the profit, and they get squeezed off our supermarket shelves. We think this is an absolute disgrace to our farmers, and we believe in supporting our farmers.